Yo, viewers, today we're going to be filming video of the day. I believe we're up to number 20 now. Thus far, the day is not going to plan. This week I had seen some signs advertising some pretty good size tag sales a couple towns over. I was going to go to those this morning and then stop by a restaurant I like on the way home, have that for lunch. When I got up this morning to go to the sales, I was still tired, so I says, nah, I went back to sleep because I had to stay up late last night for something, so that did not work out. But that's fine, so I went back to sleep, and now it's almost 11:30. So, a bit behind on the day, but that's fine. So, it's a beautiful day this morning. We've got some strawberries starting to come on. Sun is shining. It was forecasted to be quite a nice day, both today and tomorrow. Highs in the upper 70s with sun. And looks like that's what we're gonna get. So I got the fans going. We shouldn't need any conditioners today. It's not humid. Won't need any conditioners tomorrow either, probably. Got a couple more pepper plants sitting here in the sun waiting to be planted. So, what we're going to do today is, I got some things outside that we're going to look at. There's a stupid would-be. Goes and drills holes in the deck and everything. What a pain in the neck. Staircase is holding up pretty good still. Cut the lawn yesterday, that looks nice. This spring, I dethatched the yard. I dethatched this side and I stopped right around where the fence opening is. And, you know, I really don't see any difference at all. The only thing I noticed was this side here, which took a very long time to get going. Well, that's what happened. It stayed looking junky for an additional month or so. That side had filled in, came back to life. Looked green and lush, and then this was just taking forever to come in. Now granted, it has come in exceptionally this year, and there's not a bare spot anywhere, but I'm pretty sure that's the way it was last year. So I'm just not sure that was worth the time or worth losing a month of nice grass. Yeah, the line, it would have been somewhere right in here, and I really don't see any difference. So I'm not sure that we're gonna do that again next year. Alright, so one of the things that we can do today is we can try to clean out some of this brush. I'm gonna remove some of this brush up until about here. So we'll leave this collection here and take this collection out because it never grew back right. This is horizontal, that's not going to grow right. This is horizontal. Most of these pieces are horizontal. So this is the batch that had the tree fall on it. So I was hoping that it would kind of spring back a little better than this, but it's not. So I think we're just going to cancel it out. And once I cancel it out, it'll be better for the health of this tree anyways, because as of right now, this tree is not getting a whole lot of airflow around it, which can cause it to rot, especially in these very damp conditions. So we'll clean that up and get a little more airflow for this tree. We'll take out some of these other miscellaneous pieces and pull out all that junk. I had pulled out a lot of it last year and just a few pieces came back. So we'll finish that up and then clean up some of the brush that's over here. Just a couple twigs and small branches left. And then this will look really nice in here. So that's not necessarily a project for today. That's just a project to do in the next couple of weeks. And then as I clean up the garden, I'm trying to build this area up because this gets all soggy here, real bad. It's not good. So what I did was I put some extra dirt here. As I was cleaning the weeds out of the garden, I've been dumping the dirt here. And so this area would have normally been the same. And it's still kind of soggy, but it's much better. So I'm thinking maybe I'll dump, because you can see it goes down here. It goes down about maybe 2 inches. See where the grass stops growing. And it just gets too soggy. So if I can build this whole area up 2 or 3 inches, up to the rocks, and then plant some grass, it'll look much better. What is that? That looks like, almost looks like a dog. Yeah, this is walkable here. It's not great, but it's what it is. So these two trees here, I cut all this brush away from these trees for the airflow. You see these trees, unfortunately, are starting to rot. I'm not sure how many more years we're going to have with these trees. And the ferns coming in nice. This tree's got a little hole in it. And it's not too bad. It should last a couple more years, but it is showing some signs of not being the greatest anymore. It's too bad because these two are beautiful trees and they make a nice shade here. Without these trees, the whole yard would just be baking in the sun, as would the deck. The deck would be totally unusable until 5 or 6 o'clock without these trees. Oak tree just popped up recently. I'm not sure if I should leave it or take it out. Eventually I'm going to need to replace this tree. I'd much rather have an oak than a maple because the oaks are strong, but I don't think that this oak is going to survive with this much water. Oaks don't really like that. These are swamp maple trees. They can take the water. So this is not good here. There's some rot in there. Otherwise, I think, aside from that, this tree is in pretty good shape still. It is starting to split. So I got it cabled up. I got two cables up there now. And during the winter time, the cables were, they had some slack to them. Now that all the leaves have come on, it looks to me like the cables, they're not pulled taut completely. I've seen them get pulled taut once when we had the ice storm. But there's not as much slack, which makes sense because of all the extra weight from the leaves. But the cable's working, so I think it's fine. I'll leave this alone for as long as I possibly can. It's splitting pretty good over here, but it just seems solid to me. You know, I watch it in the wind, and it doesn't move much. So. See what happens with those. This, I think I'm going to cancel this out because this is just kind of a nuisance. You can't walk under here and whatever. Water level's kind of low right now. Jeez, I just fell. I don't know if I'll get to this today, but eventually I want to come over here and we'll clean up all these grass. All the grass. We'll take out some of these things to thin this out. And my neighbor wants me to help him take this tree that fell over out and make this look nice back here. So we'll get to that eventually. That's going to take some time. This was another swamp maple tree. You can see it just rotted out in the center. Eventually, that's probably what these two are gonna do. But these two are much, much larger than that other tree was. So for whatever reason, these two are surviving. So I think that they're gonna last a couple more years at least, I hope. beautiful area back here. And if it was baking in the sun, it would just, it would not be as usable. I always enjoy the foliage coverage. Grass just looks absolutely fantastic this year. It looked pretty good last year, but it wasn't quite like this. This is exceptional. So another thing we can do today is we can clean up the deck, under the deck here. Gotta get all these leaves out of here. And I wanna set up a second, do I have a second pallet? Yeah, I do, it's over there. I kinda wanna set up a second pallet for washing air conditioner. Because the problem is this is so tilted here, this way this is like this. We can just put this chair somewhere and clean up that stuff, put those buckets away, but all this stuff away will cancel that air conditioner out. Put those pots in the garage, you gotta cancel that stuff out, and then see what we're gonna do with these doors. I've been thinking of making a table, but I don't know. And maybe this year we'll get to this light. That'll be an interesting project. Let's see how our little birds are doing. And they're growing up. All right, so the major projects for today that I want done today are going to be side of the house here in this garden. So I want to clean up this garden completely. I want to get all the weeds and junk out of there. I'm going to get this out of here. This is some kind of a tree started growing here. So I think it's still trying to come back, but we're going to pull that out. That might be interesting. We're going to have to use the pick. I was going to put a chain to it and pull it out with the vehicle, but now that the grass is growing in nicely, I don't want to do that. So we'll have to do it manually with the pick. And we'll use the action hoe to clean up all these weeds. And we'll dump all this stuff back in that wet area to build that soil. That's what I've been building it up with. So we'll do that. And then we'll plant those blueberry bushes in the living room into here. Get those out of the living room. And then over here, along this side of the house, I'm gonna take those these two trees that I have over here in front, which I planted, and they're not doing too good. These two here. This one. And this one, they're alive, they got plenty of new growth on them, but they're just not doing anything because these are sun plants. These like the sun, and obviously they don't get much sun being under the trees. So this was just a incorrect choice. I don't know why I did that. I guess I didn't realize that these were sun plants. So we're going to take these two out. We're going to get some hostas. We got to go to the store. I'm gonna get some hostas, put the hostas in over here, because hostas can tolerate the shade. And then we'll put the those two bushes back over here. We'll put them in here, on the side of the house. We'll get this all cleaned up. Clean up all this grass that's growing here. Get that out. And we'll try to trim this back a little bit on this side to separate the two bushes, and then we'll put one here, and then I have another bush for my mother, and then we'll put in the middle and clean this up too. This is a lilac that I grabbed from the front. Two little shoots coming up, so that will grow up eventually. Fertilize that, hopefully that can grow up a little faster. This is the total growth of the grass this year. I just kind of left that here because it's kind of interesting to see how tall the lawn would be if I never cut it. So that's that. That's the stuff for today. And then of course I got a bunch of videos I want to film today. So this is going to take, might take an hour to get this cleaned up, because I don't know what's going to be entailed for that stupid tree in the corner. That might take some time to do that by hand. So I'll give about an hour for that. This might take about an hour as well, because I have to scalp up some of the grass also with the action hoe. And I'll move it. I guess I'll move it over here. I'll try to put it over here. Fill this in, because we're getting some erosion here. Maybe I'll try to put it here or over here. The soil's better over here. I guess it's got a better chance of growing there. So we'll do that. And see what happens with that stuff. So far the trees are still looking okay. I do believe that there is some of the stupid gypsy moth in them this year. I can hear it at night. And I did notice that the tree in the front in the right, which is already kind of in bad shape, that one, some of the leaves are a bit chewed up. They're also a very different color. Yeah, these two oak trees and then the big one over there are a bright green, and they're still very lush and soft, whereas the ones on that tree on the right, those leaves are a much darker color. It's not as vibrant, and the leaves are very thick and hard. To me, they almost seem like they're more developed. I don't know, it's kind of weird. Oh, it's beautiful foliage coverage now in the yard. Oof, better get that cleaned up, it's filthy. All right, let's, we're gonna get going here. I'm gonna go inside and do a couple things on the computer, look at some email, whatever. And then I'll eat something, then we'll go to the store. Might do lunch when I come back from the store, and then we'll get a move on stuff depending on how hungry I am. It's gonna be a nice evening today if this weather keeps up. Hear that? I believe that's those stinking owls again. I'm not going through another spring like this. I'm gonna start using that air horn I got. See if that gets rid of them. What an annoying sound, and it's just constant. We'll go into the store now. I think we're just gonna get the two Hosta and be done with it. I wanna put up at least two more street lights in the yard in the near future. So I gotta buy the apparatus to build the mounts. But I think there's going to be a lot of people at the store today, because it's the middle of the day and it's a holiday weekend. I don't like to go to the store during the day in the first place. It's going to be worse than usual. So I think we'll just get the Hostas and go. I'm trying to go through the store and get all the other stuff. It's going to be ridiculous. As it is, the amount of traffic on this road alone is out of hand. It's not slow, but there's way more people than there usually is. seemed so bad. Jeez. It doesn't seem so bad as of now, anyways. Definitely a lot of people here, but it's not quite as bad as I thought it was going to be. It still is going to take some time, though, to get the stuff. too crazy there. I got some tools, a couple tools for $3. They're a little rusty. We got to clean them up, but I think they'll come out okay. So now we'll go back home and take care of these plants. It's getting hot out with the sun anyways. Well, we've got the nice low humidity day. Let's go ahead and air out the downstairs. It's 79 over 47 out. 72 or 46 in. Warm it up a little bit down here. And we'll turn on this 8000 CFM 3733 in just a moment. Actually, I suppose we can just put it in this other window here. This is kind of an unusual one I've never seen before. This is the Shadowland Wee Hosta, which allegedly is the Hosta of the year. And we have this one, which is much more standard. This is a Hosta hybrid, which is pretty standard. Okay, I gotta talk on the phone now. Stupid owls are going crazy right now. So this whole clip is gonna be filled with that annoying screaming sound. So we're gonna get these out first. Try to dig the hole about the size of the new pots. Save as much of these roots as possible. These haven't grown much at all. This is not the right location for this plant. There's hardly any roots there. This will do much better in a new location.
know if this is on top of a root. That's not good. Yep, there's the main root right there for the oak tree. Probably runs kind of like this. So that means we got to move the... I'm not disturbing that root, so we got to move the... past the... I guess over to the right just a little bit. I'll have to put it here. Hopefully there's no more roots in the way. Getting close to the tree root again right here. So yeah, that's the tree right there. So we can't go any further that way. So we gotta keep going this way instead. That kind of stinks, but I'm not gonna disturb the tree. These are beautiful trees here. I won't want anything to happen to them. So we'll move the plant. Won't be perfectly in line with the other one, but it is what it is. This one has grown through the bottom a fair bit, so we might have to cut the pot open. Nope, I got it. Okay, that's a wrap on these. Some weeds coming up. Put the mulch down soon and take care of that. Okay. Gypsy moth. This should all grow much better now. Now we got to move over to location number 2. And get everything cleaned up and get the ground ready for these two plants that was here.
garage, making it a lot more tolerable over here. It's hot in the sun and it's kind of stagnant over here. That'll take a couple days to regrow up towards the sun, but that'll reshape in itself and look fine, probably by the end of the week.
bit of a miscut. Take off too much. That's okay.
We better thin it out anyway. Yeah.
Okay, things are looking a lot better now.
bare spot right here. I think I'm just going to stick it here.
on hill is pretty good though. Thank you.
look as bad as I thought they did. I think these will be fine here. So we've got a stopping point here. The camera's just about out of charge, and quite frankly, so am I, so let's take a break for lunch. Here's what we got for lunch. We've got salmon, corn, and cherries. So in terms of cost, this salmon piece cost $23.72. This is 1.1 pounds. That's a little steep. You could get this for probably about maybe $17 or $16. This one is already pre-made. It's got the, it's cut well. It's got the that delicious stuff on there. This is two meals. So it's about, we'll say $11 for that. This was $1, so there's $12. And these were $11. These are very expensive. I've already eaten these once. There's two more servings left. So we'll say that's about $4. So $5 and $11, $16 meal. That's outrageous for something prepared at home. But what's even more outrageous, if you get this at a restaurant, $30-something, maybe $35. It's crazy. But you know, I don't eat this every day, so $16 for a nice healthy meal. It is what it is. It's getting a little bit much though. But this actually, I think, has the skin taken off already as well. So what we're going to do is we're going to cut this in half. Now it's 4 o'clock right now, so I think this will be the only full meal I have today. I might eat something later on tonight. I most definitely will, most likely, but it won't be another full meal. Yep, the skin is taken off of this. So this is nicely prepared. That's why it's a little more expensive. Very clean, trimmed up cut. I'll put this in the oven here for about 20 minutes.
20 or 25 minutes. And we'll do about 250, 300, 275 maybe. I find the temperatures of all the cooking needs to be less in that small oven because it's so close to the element, it'll get burnt. Well, not burnt, but it'll, you know, get crispy or dry out faster than it would in the oven. So even though fish, you can cook it at 400 degrees, in something like that, I'm going to almost halve it and we'll still get the same cooking result. All right, so we'll put this in. Actually, you know what I'm going to have tonight? I know what I'm going to have tonight. Every so often, the seafood department puts out this. This is lobster mac and cheese. This was $13.91. I've already eaten this once, so eat it twice. So this was about, what was that, $7 a portion. So we'll have that for dinner.
That's super expensive. I don't buy that stuff very often at all.
But when I have it, I do tend to get it. Because it is fantastic. Before we go any further, I'm going to wash off these scissors because they get all fish slime on there. Okay, now we'll peel the corn. This corn was only a dollar. I don't know if it would have been cheaper to buy frozen corn. Frozen corn ain't the cheapest thing out there, though. So I don't know. You know, I think I'm going to have two pieces of this. I only bought this 2 days ago, but I forgot to put it in the fridge overnight once. And I think that, it's going bad quick. See, it's already all shriveled up and everything. Maybe I'll have the third piece tonight. We have one rancid spot on here. I don't think that's from leaving it out. I think that's from mishandling.
So we'll just go ahead and cancel that out. Don't work the greatest with onion skin and corn husks. If I had a whole bunch of them, I would just put them in the trash or outside or something. Thank you.
wait for that to not even boil, just start to simmer. The corn will turn a little bit darker in color, then we'll flip it and get the other side. It only cook for maybe 2-3 minutes. That's it. Anything more than that, it'll get kind of mushy and nasty.
It's almost ready to turn. Sometimes this just fits perfectly and sometimes it doesn't. Right now it's not. I don't know what the difference is.
Go figure, after all that work in the beating sun, it just got cloudy. Well, I'm gonna set up the umbrella for lunch anyways. I think this is the first time this year I've used these umbrellas. Okay, this is definitely going to be ready to turn now. Yep. See that difference in the color? Oh, maybe you can't see it, but this is a little bit darker. You got another maybe 2 minutes on that side, and then that's done. And this is just about done as well. It's going to be a nice lunch. Time to clean up from the lunch now. That was an excellent lunch. Very relaxing outside. The fish was good, the corn was good. The cherries were kind of inconsistent. Some of them were okay, some of them were a little gross. Thank you. Okay, now we're gonna go back outside for a little while, clean up from the planting, and maybe get the blueberries in place if I can clean the garden up quick enough. Only gonna spend about an hour more outside, but I gotta do some other things today too. Got a few pieces of grass left. I think I will try to put them over here.
This might not take because the ground is very shallow here, but better than just throwing it out. Let me just give it a shot. We'll come back and water it later.
I'm going to add some fertilizer to the rose bush and the lilac on the end. Small pebbles. Not good in the yard. Those can get in the lawnmower and break stuff. You know, fling at a window or something. That's it for this area. It's at least for today. These raspberries gotta go somewhere still. But this looks much better than I did before. Get that third bush and this will be done for now. So let's move on to part two.
Now this is taking a lot of dirt away, but I don't care because I'm reusing the dirt. If I wasn't going to reuse the dirt, I'd do it differently.
this is all busted. Gotta fix that. There's those stupid owls again. I don't intrinsically think owls are stupid, I just hate the sound. Thank you. grass here. Thank you.
What I did here was I put some grass clippings down and then I put the dirt on top of it. And it seems pretty solid here. It's a little squishy, but it's pretty reasonable considering what we're working with. So we'll see how this holds up over time. This is, you can at least walk here as opposed to this, which is just, this is ridiculous. So give it a couple of rainstorms. And if this holds, then I'll keep putting the grass clippings here. And as I clean up different parts of the yard, I'll put the dirt here. And then hopefully over time, we can build up the level here all the way to the rocks so that it's good grass all the way back. It's gonna take some time, but as long as this works, we can get it there. Probably raise it up about 2 or 3 inches already. It might be more like 4 or 5, but we'll see. Let's see if we can get this thing out, and then if I can, that'll be our stopping point with this for today. Because I can plant tomorrow morning, we'll have some time. But I want to get this done first because I don't know how far the roots are going to go over. And the more I stand here and work here, it gets packed down, so I don't want to turn it over, then work on this and pack it back down again. It just doesn't make any sense. This might be tough. This has been here for some time. My neighbor told me he cut this tree down when it was getting out of control before I bought the house. And it looks like, and we've got a several inch diameter thing here which still has plenty of life in it. So this is not going to come out without a fight. Really should have done this over the winter. And the ground was somewhat frozen, but not totally frozen. At least before the grass came up. And move the camera further away from this. Got some big roots on it. Working with probably a good 3-inch stem here. We gotta get this down pretty far, otherwise it's gonna keep coming back.
It's gonna take some time. And ideally, we should pull out most of these roots too. I might gotta get an axe out, actually. That's what I might use. So it looks like the roots kind of go this way. Definitely cut one of them off. We only got one of the two big systems on there.
ruining the yard over this, so we're just gonna cut it here. Fix this up. I didn't realize this was totally busted. Alright, we got it. I went down pretty deep and the soil is really good over here. As I turn over the garden this year, we'll get a lot of these roots out. Okay, I'm gonna wrap it there today for the garden. I'm gonna get rid of that stump, put the tools away, and then we'll move on to something else. Just to show how powerful that action hoe is, I don't know what this is here, but this is about an inch, and it cut right through that. It's a great tool. I just got back from cleaning up a lawn. I wanted to film it, but I didn't film it because I didn't think so that I would have enough time to finish if I was playing with the camera. And I was correct. I would not have. I just barely finished. Night caught me and the dew caught me as well. So now we're going to have to clean off the lawnmower deck, because all the grass was sticking to it. So I'm going to go ahead and turn on all the street lights now, because we're going to be outside for some time still. Got a few more miscellaneous things I got to put away. And got to clean up the mower, and we got to water some of the stuff that we planted today. So here we go. Go take a look outside as all these warm up. Crickets going. I like the crickets and I like the cicadas. The cicadas usually don't come out until the latter portion of the summer. I have really been enjoying the street lights this year, especially this one here that I put in the side yard. This mounting apparatus came out really good. I've had some people ask, like, what is it with the sodium lights? And the questions must be coming from younger people, because this is what nighttime looked like when I was growing up. Sodium was still king until about 5 years ago, at least around here. All the town roads seemed to start getting changed out around 2018, and a lot of the state roads didn't get changed out until even last year. So these really, it's amazing how long these were around. It was such a good lighting technology, and it still is. I actually think in a lot of ways it's superior to DEL, but that's a whole different story. But I always liked the night. I was always a night person. I like to stay up late and go out and do things at night. And this is what night looked like. If you was outside at night, there was this orange glow. And when I first got my license, I was back in, 2012, I guess? 2013 maybe, everything was still sodium. And I remember driving down the freeways at night for the first time, you know, coming home from whatever I was doing, and sodium lights everywhere. I have one memory from a long, long time ago. My mother used to work it sometimes in the evening. And so my grandmother would go and pick me up from school, and my grandfather would drive me home later on that night. And I just remember this one particular intersection where there was a sodium light, and the sodium light would, that orange glow would come through the car, and I just remember that moment for whatever reason. I remember that vividly. So these are very nostalgic to me, this orange glow. This is surprisingly balanced. I thought this was really going to put a lot of weight on the fence here, but it really doesn't. I wonder if we could double the height of this. It might be interesting just to try. I think it would actually be okay, especially if I drop this to the ground, you know, so it would only be adding 6 feet as opposed to 8. I might give that a shot sometime. Should really do it now before I put the wiring in, because once I put the plug on, then it's like you can't really change the height too much. But yeah, this apparatus is great. I'm glad I figured this out. So on a less positive note, I believe that I have an infestation of the gypsy moth this year. Typically they come around like once a decade, and I'm getting very concerned about the trees, because I noticed a week ago that one of the trees in particular, a lot of the leaves seemed like they were chewed up, as if like a lot of wind or something came through. And I don't know if it's picking up on the camera, especially now with the crickets going, but you can kind of hear it. Almost sounds like it's very lightly raining. And apparently that sound is the sound of the droppings from the stupid caterpillars falling on the leaves as they eat them. And so that's kind of disgusting. I really don't even want to be outside under these trees right now, even though I always like to spend the afternoon out here in the yard. It's gross. Like, there's just droppings falling everywhere. I don't know what to do about this. See, if we come over here, you can, you can see this. That leaf is all chewed up. I think I'm going to do a separate segment of this, and maybe somebody can give me some advice here. But see this? The leaf is all chewed up. This is what some of the leaves look like. So this is very concerning to me. It's not too bad yet. You know, the trees have plenty of good leaves on them still, but It's quite common for these stupid things to chow through the whole entire tree and completely defoliate the tree. And I'll be very, very upset if that happens. So, I don't know. I'm not sure what to do about this. From what I understand, the natural enemy of the gypsy moth is some type of fungus that typically only grows when it's very damp and humid out for a while. Today was nice, tomorrow's supposed to be nice as well, and then it's supposed to start raining. Now, normally I would not welcome the rain and high humidity, but I guess this year that'll be a positive. So hopefully it stays humid and rainy for a while, enough at least for that fungus to develop, and hopefully that fungus will start killing them off. So otherwise, I don't know what to do. I found a couple companies that will come and spray the trees, but I don't know. I feel like that's not going to work, because if you spray these trees and the neighbors don't spray all the trees, then why wouldn't they just come right back? Ugh, it's always something. Supposedly they mostly go after oaks, so at least these maple trees should hopefully be okay. I don't see any holes shooting these leaves. These trees I just get nervous with because I know that they're not 100%. Those oak trees in the front probably are 100%, but these are, I don't think that these are. So I really don't want anything to happen that would stress out these trees. Alright, so all the street lights are warmed up. I'm gonna get the tripod back, we'll clean up the lawnmower. And then we'll water some of the plants, and then do a couple videos, and then I'll wrap up the day. Here's that hose reel from the curbside day.
I was originally going to throw this out because the water apparatus wasn't working right, but then I decided not to because I figured I'd just use it for storage. I don't know why that didn't occur to me initially. Quite frankly, I wish I grabbed every hose reel I saw, because just storing it on reels saves so much time. It's not as convenient as if the water hookup worked, but it's much better than trying to coil it up into a coil, and then it gets tangled and, you know, kinks up and whatever. This is so easy. And now we're ready to use the hose. It's not tangled, it's not kinked, it's just ready. So we'll take this end and we'll just go over here. I'm gonna use the short hose to water the or to clean the lawnmower. Usually I unravel the hose over here and works a lot better. I don't know why I didn't do that today. Here we go back to that thing about when you're doing something on video, it just takes longer because your attention is now split between trying to film and what's actually going on. Before I water the plants, I think I'm going to wash the lawnmower first so that can start to dry off. It's not going to dry now because the dew has come on, but at least stop dripping before I bring it back in the house. The bag too, because this is what happens, is it gets this clogs here. This is clogged now, air is not getting through this, and it just stops working good. So I'll rinse all that out. It's still wet, so it'll come off real easy. And I'll rinse off the deck of the mower as well. I'm gonna get a different nozzle on here. I have what I got here. I've got this, and we can use that with this. This is busted. Where is the... And also use this one. This works pretty good for like a pressure washing or something.
I also got this one. This is a 10-year warranty, but this is pretty big. I think that's higher volume more so than higher pressure. I thought I had something else for watering, but I can't find it now. I had one like this, but it was circular. It was from that stupid watering wand that broke. For how much I water plants and all this stuff, I really should have a decent piece of equipment, but I just don't. Alright, well, I guess, you know, I have a bag for gaskets, and yet there's just a million gaskets floating around in here like it's nothing.
We'll do this, we'll, put it on here. Okay, I don't know what that's about. This is so, it's got like some kind of paper on there, it seems. Who knows? Okay. Actually, no, I don't think we'll need another hose. This thing kind of works. It's not great, but it suffices for now until I find a vintage one.
It's actually not anywhere near as bad as I thought it was going to be. But it definitely needs to be cleaned.
This is surprisingly easy to clean up.
Why we do this under the stairs, because it makes a mess.
All right, I'll go discard this, and we'll be back on the video.
First thing we're going to water is the pack of sander I just put here.
This will always require watering because it's under the overhang. So unless we get a driving rain with wind to the side, this never sees water.
Okay, we're done with the small hose now. We're going to try this nozzle tonight. And I put a regulator on here because sometimes the spray is just too powerful and just knocks the plants over. doesn't have a gasket in there, does it? Nope. Well, it's a good thing there's a whole bunch of them sitting in the hose thing in the garage. The video is a bit overexposed right now because I had the exposure ramped up for the outside. Yeah, for some reason I just get the feeling that that's not going to work. I don't see what the gasket is going up against. I see it now. This might require two gaskets. I don't think so. That's going to work. All right, I'll try that. If it leaks, then I'll try something different. Let's charge it up and see if it leaks. The water probably is not here yet. Yep, it leaks all over. Oh gosh. Well. Right, okay. Well, needless to say, we're going to have to use a different nozzle, because this is spraying out all over the place, over here, this is leaking. That gets a zero, can't use that. I guess this whole apparatus should really just be discarded. I'll take the gaskets out first, but this whole ordeal is not worth anything. Alright, I'll go grab a different one. I tried this one yesterday, and I liked that it has this kind of adjustment, because you can put it on slowly, and it's just easier to adjust on the lower levels. But the holes weren't coming out right, so I think that maybe it's clogged with sediment or something. We might be able to clean that out. This one is okay, but it squeaks when you put it on a lower setting. So if we use that one, we need to get a regulator. And now for some psychotic reason, I'll put all these back as if I'm going to use them again someday. Like this is still in there, that's totally useless. This actually would probably work. Wonder if that one works. Well, I guess we'll give it a shot. We don't have many other options here. So I got two of these. Oh, there's a different. This one's Melnor. Yeah, let's try this one. Last year I said this is stupid, I'm gonna buy a new one. And I bought a new watering one that it broke in like a week. It was abysmal. So I really am just gonna wait until I find a vintage one, because that's all that's worth having. And this is missing a gasket. So I'll just take it out of this one, which will cause a problem later on. You know what, I'm not gonna do that. Let's just do something better. Get a different one. You know, this really shouldn't be so difficult. Okay, take 50. I remember this one. This thing's a piece of junk. This came with the that apparatus for washing the vehicle. And this, I could never get this to thread on properly. Something about the threads was not made right. There's a surprise. And this has never, I've never had success with this. Let's see if I can get it. Nope, see, it just constantly cross threads. Well, let it cross thread, I don't care anymore. It's already busted up. As long as it don't leak, that's as far as I'm concerned. Oh yeah, it's leaking everywhere. Abysmal. Totally abysmal. Let's try again. This is starting to get irritating.
have any more regulators in here? I don't think so that I do. I've got this one, but that's kind of absurd. That one doesn't work. This doesn't spray right. Well, I guess we just won't have a regulator. Whatever. This is taking too long. I ain't got time for this. Well, this is kind of leaking. Oh gosh, it's totally leaking. Leaking everywhere. Okay. Use the squeaking one because that's all we have. I think I have one more in there. Okay, one more. Last one. This is going to be annoying. Nope, I can't. That's going to be so infuriating. I can't use that. This one, we might as well just discard that one, too. Okay, I've got nothing left besides... I got nothing left besides that stupid squeaky one. Or this one. I guess I'll use this one. The problem with this one is... you get some good spray, and then, like... a concentrated area that digs a hole in the ground. So this one's kind of a joke too, but it's the least of a joke out of the 74 that we've tried tonight. This here, that digs a hole in the ground, that top spray, because it's very heavy. Which is a shame, because this is super easy to use. Get a nice gentle spray or full power. It just should be so simple. Okay, we'll start out with the corn. It seems like it's kind of dark. Can this go brighter? I guess that's as bright as it will go. Alright, we're gonna have to live with it.
This is corn.
The stupid stream at the top is blasting on the house, and then the water nicely goes in the plant. This nozzle stinks too. They all stink.
Every stinking one I have stinks. That stinks. This is a stinking joke. I gotta spray it like this so the stinking dryer doesn't get water in here. Something's got to be clogged. I can't tell. But it sure is annoying. Thank you. This particular section of the grass always dries out quick. I think the soil is shallow here. So I just go along this side of this and add some extra water every day. And so far this year it's been doing well. I do the same thing to the front on the other side, right by the edge of the driveway. It always seems to dry out, so I just add some extra water.
this doesn't spray far enough to reach it in that mode. I'll give this one a little bit more. Just reach. It's a really reach. Okay, that's it for the watering for tonight. We're not going to water anything on the deck because it just doesn't need it. So we can put the hose away now, put these rest of these buckets and trash cans away, and then we'll spray some neem oil, and that'll be it for the outdoor activities tonight.
works fine for weeks. And as soon as I put a camera on, it doesn't work. That's typical.
That's going to be a wrap for today. I'm going to spray the neem oil in the morning because it's getting tired and I'm getting late. So I've just left the tools here and put them back where they go because I'm going to try to plant the blueberries tomorrow. And I got the humidifier on in here that should dry out the lawnmower in the bag overnight and it'll be all dry in the morning. All right, that's it for this one. The day has come to a close. I still need to take a bath. I'm filthy from doing all the work outside. And I think I'm finna have that lobster macaroni and cheese. But that'll be it for today, for today's activities. Wasn't the most interesting day, but hopefully there's some people that enjoyed the gardening stuff. It was gonna be more interesting than it was, but I didn't end up getting to those tag sales like I had planned because getting the sleep was more important because that's a matter of health and safety. So I did that instead. So that's all for now. Here's a look at the deck. The deck is looking nice with all the plants and everything and the lights on the trees and so forth. We are ready here for summer.